By April 1978, the league trophy was being presented to the team of ne'er-do-wells who had pipped Liverpool for the championship. Brian Clough, with Peter Taylor alongside him, had become only the second manager in the history of the game to win the league with two different clubs.
They underestimated us. It's the best way to go into anything, when they know, when they think they're going to win. We. There's nowt certain in this life. Not in football.
Once again, Clough had bounced back from adversity. Now he was poised to take the final step that would crown his career. His old rival, Don Revie, had failed as England manager and scuttled off to a highly paid job in the Middle East.
A bit cold, isn't it?
Despite his past run-ins with the FA, they were obliged to interview Clough when it became clear he was the people's choice for the job.
Do you feel that what you've done for Forest you could do with the England side?
I think managing a side, whether it's England, Forest or Hartlepool, that's where Peter and I started, it is the same thing. Management's essential in any football club, however big or however small. And I feel the Football Association should have the best manager. And please don't ask me who that is.
They were scared stiff of him. Absolutely scared stiff of his style, his way of management. Take out the equation that he was so successful, that's what they should have been looking at.
In the end, fear triumphed at Lancaster Gate, and Clough was passed over.
I think they gave it Ron Greenwood. Typical Football Association decision. Ron, charming man. Wouldn't hurt a fly. Couldn't fall out with his wife to save his life. And was a nice man. They didn't want any trouble. They didn't want me. They thought, they were shrewd enough to think, that I was going to take over the FA, which I was going to. I'd have taken over lock, stock and barrel.